G'day all, MrPaladin here. I've been having lots of games with Deadly recently, and Deadly's playing DPS right now, and I'm supporting as Anna, doing some of the regular Anna things, being a little DPS-y myself. But as 222 came in, I've had the pleasure of, instead of being a flex player on tank and support all the time, I've gone DPS myself, so I wanted to show a bit of footage from that. And joined with us today in voice is Deadly and Will.
Hello.
First round we have here is, what is it, Lunar Colony. I did not even know you got hit here. I'm busy firing off at the teammates there and Moira sending you an orb.
Yeah, well, I got hit with a sonic arrow, so I was just like, you know what, I'm just going to hide here.
But we were really popping off. There was a lot of nice things that happened during the Anna play here. I don't usually play a lot of Anna, mostly because my accuracy is not really great, but hey, I'm improving. But I do a lot of funny stuff, like Moira's ulting, so I'm like, you know what, I'm just gonna nano the Moira. Why not? You know, I don't do the regular Anna stuff. I don't like doing meta stuff. But even though, you know, the meta is in place, I like having fun, and that's what the 222 has let me do recently. You're waiting for that dank Deadeye, and look, you're hurt, but I'm not even looking at you. Yeah, I've got other stuff.
I'm just looking at you, though, just like, hello?
And then I'm like, I got you covered. I had to reload, and there you go. I'll tell you what.
Oh, if that shield wasn't there, that would have been a good time for that Deadeye.
Well, look at this Deadeye. You still got the shield in place, but you know what? The timing is everything. Poop up.
People often forget that Deadeye lasts that long. In lower elo games, like sort of before Master, you can really just hold it and people forget about it.
Oh, what's his sleep dart on the Tracer? I was hoping somebody would be able to capitalize on that because I didn't think I had enough damage myself.
And I just happened to be looking that way. You're going.
It really is a strange ELO at where we're at because, you know, you don't need to be the meta. You can just be whatever is fun and it can work out well. Like, I had a game the other day where I was a tank as Sigma and we had a Hog along and I'm like, man, they're just going to push into us. But together, Hog and me as Sigma, we worked out great. Ooh, you're looking for the Deadeye. You got one. That's good enough for defense.
That's all you need.
Yep. We'll be able to pick off the rest.
Deadeye is generally a very useless ult, so much to the point that people use it literally for reloading. So getting one pick of it is fine.
I love the aggression from our Ryan actually here. So much so that I think I nano the Czar here. She was powered up. And this is all from that Deadeye, right?
Yeah, well, that's what got it started.
Yeah, couldn't save you
oh,
there.
Oh, that's a whole lot. Get out of there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, missed the sleep dart on that Reaper. I've been loving playing Reaper and timing my own fades on that. I think I saved the Czar from a Deadeye there.
What's even better, though, is you missed the sleep dart on a trapped Reaper. Like, he was in Junkrat's trap when he
did I didn't know he was trapped. I don't pay attention to such things. I tell you, the Hog's got anti on him. I regret nothing about that sleep.
I just make sure to kill the Hog before I die.
That's the job of the DPS. Kill the tanks.
I mean, we just need to slow down this attack. We get our own spawns here. I get to wander on out because I don't have any movement skills. You get at least a roll. And speaking of movement skills, we get to walk up the staircase. It's like there's no fast way to get up. We're constantly going up the staircase.
But roll is normally a terrible movement speed, but I think twice in this game, I use it to avoid Sigma's ult. Like, he nice. Ults, and then I just roll, and I'm out of it. But normally you want to use it to reload, because it's way more valuable as that.
Oh, watch for the Reaper here. I remember this.
Oh, sneaky.
And then I'm like, you know what? I should nano boost the run. It is the proper thing to do. Instead of nano boosting a Moira or something.
And round. GG. Mm-hmm.
So then we were like, you know what, let's just queue up DPS. And actually we lost the first round of this round, I remember that.
Oh yeah, you can see it, top right.
Mm-hmm. So they were actually doing pretty good, but we separate off the right here. They spend way too much trying to get me and I just cube it up. Mei is really a good part of the meta right now. She's seeing a lot. Mei, Reaper.
Mei, Reaper, Doomfist, and Bastion, those are the DPS heroes. You can make other stuff work, but it's harder.
Bastion's just kind of meh, especially when it goes against a Reinhardt. Well, if the Reinhardt's sneaky anyway.
Yeah, I actually earned my golden guns again, a nice 3,000 points to spend, and I put it on Reaper because I really did climb with Reaper in the 2-2-2 this season.
I bought my golden gun for Brigitte because she actually takes skill now. You almost warded me off there.
Yeah, I thought about it, but then I'm like, you know what, I got a trap on this Reaper. And then I'm overly cautious because I'm expecting Mercy to come on in and raise the Reaper, but then Ryan charges in, Mercy sneaks in and gets the Reaper.
But, oh, she's a sneaky little Phoenix.
For showing that.
Oh, yeah, I wanted to include that bit. I'm like, you know what, McCree counters that, doesn't it?
Listen, my average accuracy is like 50%, which is good, and then you just put that in.
Well, watch this, right? I hear the Junkrat and I'm like, well, do I wall up to get to him or not? But he ends up backing out right over here as well. It doesn't matter the accuracy, though. I just want the damage to be delivered. I mean, everybody misses shots. Like, I'm missing shots right here. I'm shooting walls and stuff. That was great. And this is even better. Watch this. Boom. Even the Junkrat was like, oh, crap.
I think it took the Junkrat a second to realize, because he just stayed still. He was like, wait a minute.
Wait a cotton picking minute.
Almost picking.
And you watch, I think you guys are pushing up way too much in the spawn. Back up! My Mei wall. If I didn't put that Mei wall up, I think you guys would have kept going in.
Oh, I would have been at their spawn all the way now. As McCree, with no one
else. You were just determined to get their Junkrat. Yeah.
I've wanted him. He was mine.
Oh, watch this.
This is another one where I just hold it forever.
You break the shield, though, and that's valuable for killing off Sig.
Because they changed the ultimate, so the longer you hold it, it sort of grows exponentially on a higher health target. So, like, a fully charged McCree ult can, like, destroy Symmetra's shield, Orisa's shield, and Reinhardt's shield, and kill people behind them.
Ouch.
It's not used often, but, you know, it exists.
But as I was saying at the start of this, that I'm usually flexing, right? Before the 2-2-2 came in, I was usually a support, or I'd be actually main tanking it, because people liked off-tanking more than main tanking. But now that you can pick your roles, I'm slowly getting better at my deeps. And I actually like that. Your McCree actually said something about the accuracy, and then you missed a couple of shots. It's funny, I love the voice lines of the characters. Anyway, I'm getting better with my DPS. I know I'm far from perfect. I'm doing things, and there's ones that I like over ones that are needed. Like, I've needed to go McCree and stuff in some places, and I'm a terrible McCree. Don't make me play McCree, please.
So next time we play Overmunch, have you play McCree? Gotcha.
Oh dear lord, please don't. I could make a video about it. How terrible bad it is.
The only thing is, for me, right now I'm this. I'm normally a Genji main whenever I play DPS.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Genji is the second hero I got to Masters. But, like, he's just not good right now. Like, you can definitely do him, but you pretty much. You need to be popping off 24/7, otherwise, you may as well just go doing this.
Well, getting up is like, you just need to know when to use your skills. Like, I went into my, what is it, a cocoon or whatever it's called, against the flashbang, and then I knew I had to avoid D.Va before I threw Snowball. You know, stuff like that, you really got to know when to use your stuff at the right time. It's not just the fact that you use it, it's using it at the right time for the most value, you know?
Well, I'm still fairly new to the game in general, so I'm just kind of sticking with being a tank, 50-50 between Reinhardt and Sigma.
I've actually had to improve my Reinhardt play, and you'll probably like the next Overwatch video that I'm going to do after this sometime, because I've got the tank play getting up to diamond as well. So I've got all the rolls up to diamond this season, and that's where I want to comfortably sit.
I'm trying to get my support up to masters. I've been on a pretty good win streak up to about 3,300 right now. I'm going to try and push that.
Oh, I remember this bit. I'm like, I hear footsteps behind us, and then we hear the stuff on point. I think you react to it in a moment as well.
After I kill people.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you've got to kill people first. Then I'm like, dang, there's Hammond and there's Tracers back here as well. And I'm like, stop your spin!
He just goes in the other direction and he just does nothing for
him. May's good for stopping the rotation there. But you still need to get the damage on that. I still think he's got a little bit too much health. Oof! That felt personal.
I actually flashbanged that Reinhardt, but I was like literally half a centimeter off. Like, I would have saved your life, but it was like slightly out of position. So I'm still not totally used to McCree. I don't play him that much.
Yeah. I've come up against some really strong McCrees. He's in a good place right now.
He just counters what's good. He's not actually good himself, but he counters like Doomfist, Reaper, and to an extent he can do shield pressure with his right click and roll.
Yeah, let me May wall that off for you.
You actually, it's fine.
It grouped them up.
Yeah, like they don't know where I am, and then it breaks down right at the right point.
And I think you got poggers on that bit, right? Because it was on the point.
The thing is, I could have told you to stop, but I saw, okay, they're grouping behind there. I'm just going to let you wear it out.
There we go.
If the wall breaks down, you're just like, hello there.
Why, hello there?
Would you like to take a nice long trip to respawn?
So now you'll see what I like about Reaper. I mean, I saw that and I'm like, dive. I just called dive and I went back because, you know, calling out what they have as early as possible.
I get so much ult charge at the start of this round. Just look at my ult charge go up.
Yep.
Ooh.
Watch it.
I have my ult, like, immediately. And there it be.
That was rude.
I don't know why the Dizzy Diva decided to push into me, but I kill all of them.
Well, it's because they're on the dive meta. They've got to get in, but they got in and then they kind of split up. It was a little bit odd. You got to go in on the one target. So I reset after I get my health. That was great heals. And I'm watching. I'm cheeky. I like being a cheeky Reaper. Let's see what I can get. I take some cheeky shots on the tank, but it's this Doomfist. This poor Doomfist, my dude.
Oh, he had no idea.
And I should probably go for the support here, but I'm just trying to earn my ult off of the tanks. You see the opportunity on Orisa as well here. Diva thought she could take me on, but the Matrix only like delays Reaper. You've got to be with your team when you use it.
Well, really, if you want to beat Reaper as Diva, you've got to burst him down, like, immediately. Like, you can't let him get a shot off on you or your burst won't work. So you've got to take him by surprise.
This was probably one of my last games before I got my golden guns. Poor Doomfist. I feel bad for the Doomfist. That's twice up there now. Okay, I report the teleporter here. They're getting tricksy.
Get him, Sigma.
And here's a Q that's going to get play of the game for sure, right? No.
I come in and clean up for you, don't worry.
It's like, you stay on them and they don't even turn around, man. Look at this. And watch the Orisa.
But she can't turn around now because I got my wall up. So I'm just like, yep, you're dead.
Yeah, she should have just bailed.
I feel like she tried to at the end.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, ah.
Internal screaming intensifies.
Yeah.
Fortunately, I'm back before the next team fight, so it's good. I even helped Mercy get back. I'm helping Mercy get back.
Okay. I didn't see her on the screen, so yeah. I was like, what is this?
Yeah, she was using group up, which I like. I really like it when people use in-game commands when I'm like playing support for healing, because it lets me know exactly where they're at. This time I go for the Ana, but this Ana is so tricky. Not this Ana. I bail on Sigma.
Yeah, that Ana looks a whole lot like a Sigma.
I know to stay far enough away from the Ennis not to be hit by the nade. Then I go back to the Sigma. I'm always trying to hit the person that's in the back. three of us focus down that Orisa ult. And there we go, the fade to stop the sleep dart. That's the stuff that you've got to try and look for to get up. The timings of it, when the enemy's going to try and do it.
Oh, you almost got hit by that.
Yeah, almost. I see this opportunity because we're pushing in. Well, no, I actually dropped down because I wanted to steal the health pack from anything else that might have been retreating. There was purpose to it. I scouts on him. Yep, it was a good wall. I made use of that one.
Yeah, because we only had a couple seconds left. I just looked at the clock.
Okay, what exactly does Symmetra's wall do, though? Because I'm still new.
It's a wall that goes across the map, and it's got about 5,000 health.
Yeah, I think it's still 5,000 right now. I think they're talking about changing it.
No, they're changing it to 4,000.
So it took us a little while on this attack, even though all we need is one tick, but we're like, you know what, just wait until we get the EMP. And the Doomfist tries to ult me here. You don't do that to a Sombra. No. And even though I earned the EMP, we didn't need it. We managed to get the tick. Oh, I love Hammond's a Sombra. And that's the other thing, I've been able to play Sombra a bit more now that we're playing DPS, because before, you'd pick Sombra, and then you'd have two or three other people picking DPS because they don't trust your Sombra enough to let you be Sombra.
Honestly though, Junkertown is really good for Sigma and Reinhardt.
Ow!
Especially for Sigma's ult, just nice enclosed areas, you get the enemies grouped together and just ult them.
Oh, don't worry about that junk tire, man. This junk rat had my number as Sombra. You watch, like, right here.
I thought I might have been behind that
shield. Yep, right here. Right, the D.Va comes on down and I'm like, okay, I've got this D.Va dead to rights. Just shoot for baby D.Va, and for some reason the junk rat's on me.
You know.
Mm-hmm.
That felt a little personal.
Yeah.
What you see is Junkrat as a hidden passive where he just goes Sombra.
Well, I tell you this, right? I guarantee you this. If you want to know where the Junkrat trap is, play Sombra. You will find it every time.
I just found it and destroyed it.
No. I find it in a much, much more comical way.
I found it the normal way.
Yeah, you found it the insightful and ingenious way. Yep, thank you for feeding ball. I love Hammond's, man, when I'm playing Sombra. Ooh, you cheeky little healer girl. And you what, you don't see her. You guys are shooting ahead and I'm like shooting her up behind you.
No, she's not a threat. Not when she's on her own. Like, if she is away from her team, that's good. Because then she can't get heals to them.
Mm-hmm.
So if we keep pushing into her team, she has to keep running to try and catch up, which means they aren't getting healing, and then we just pick her off after.
Hey, guess where the Junkrat trap is? I swear to God, I landed them all the time.
I actually like how you two just kind of stared at each other and Soldier just kind of salutes you. It's like, hey, thanks for finding that for me.
Mm-hmm. There we go. I see Moira up on the left, but I'm like, you know what? You're not really a concern. Just get back.
Yeah, your focus was more on that.
Mm-hmm. And I want to save my ult because we had enough ults on that.
Feeling much better. I love the spotters, Soldier on this map. As long as your team is keeping an eye on the Electro, so I chuck that down there for any people returning.
Okay, I see the grav and I see you shooting into it, but I'm like, you know what? We need that Rhyme Shield down to make it effective. There we go. You almost get that Riptide.
It almost gets me.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. We farm Baby D.Va for a little bit. You don't want to kill Baby D.Va straight away. Just let her stay out. She's not really a threat.
Just do enough damage to where you build a little bit of ult.
Okay, I let you guys know that Ryan and Anna are going that side. You're in a nice, perfect position for it. In fact, your positioning through this whole bit was great.
They don't really have anything to stop me.
So I'm dealing with the Junkrat at the back, and guess what? I found the trap. You were just standing there! You were just standing there! What is a Junkrat trap doing up there? But not nearly as bad as the Junkrat trap is this Rhine charge, man.
Oh.
I don't... That just came out of left field for me. I did not expect that. Zarya did a great job blocking that Earth Shatter.
That's one of my favorite things to do as Reinhardt, is just an out-of-the-blue charge and just get someone for no reason.
Mm-hmm. It's like, man, we need to make a play here. Well, how about we just delete one of their heroes and just go from there? Overtime push. Everything's good. So yeah, I like Sombra and Junker Town. It's a fun little combination. We had trouble pushing out, though, at the start. And you see our entire team died, but I saw our Zarya got the Rhine, so I'm like, you know what, I'm going to get cheeky. He's going to be here alone. So I'm going to shoot him, but then I'm going to reload because I forgot to reload, and then I'm going to shoot him some more. And I like his thinking. His thinking is just get back with his team. He doesn't want to stay here. Don't want to deal with that Junkrat. But Rhine doesn't know where I'm at. And I see that you guys actually did quite well on the front line, so while I kept the Rhine out of the fight, you guys pushed up. Wonderful. Then we got that Junkrat trapped.
Are you gonna find another one of his traps, though?
Of course! But like I said, he had my number. He killed me quite sufficiently this game. In fact, I think he gets me in a little bit as well. And it's not a trap this time. I don't know how he psychically knew to shoot me, because like I'm kind of hiding in front of the payload, right? Being cheeky. Get the MP off. I did not get the Junkrat. Riptide came in.
Yep.
I love how you're like sacrificing your support, but then you make up for it by turning around and killing that Anna. Oh my goodness.
What the heck was that just flew off your screen in the corner? What?
And the Moira made it out with you, which was nice.
Yeah, well, I don't got time to think about the Moira. She's got to think about herself. Like, I can't do much to help her there, but she can help herself.
Keeping Rhine shields down. Yeah, keeping Rhine shields down is what I do. But you watch this Junkrat. He's like got other things to concern himself with. But who does he hit? You.
Of course.
You. You Australian son of a... I like how I'm like kicked up with my foot in the air too on the ragdoll. Like so dainty.
It's like in any multiplayer game ever, just ragdolls are amazing.
They push us back a little with ults here. Rhine decides to give up his life.
That's the thing that I see a lot of people do as Reinhardt. They just charge in and hope that they get someone. That's not how you use the charge. You got to make sure that you're guaranteed to get someone with
it. I had some perfect Reinhardt charges in the next tank video I'm going to do. You're going to love it.
100%. You didn't have anything wrong, especially the one on the Bro, I love that.
Wait for it. We won't talk about it now. We'll talk about it when the video comes up. I see that work you did on the Junkrat, so I'm going to go see what's going on. But then I see the Rhine splitting off left, and I'm like, you know what? He's got Earth Shatter. I know he's got Earth Shatter by now. So I'm calling it, you know, watch the back. The Earth Shatter's coming from the back.
He just charges.
Team's able to compensate for it because they knew it was headed that way. That's a spy's life right there, you know? I love playing 2-2-2 DPS. I love the fact that I can play Sombra without the team being utterly incompetent, you know?
Deadly, what are you doing sleeping on the payload? Get up.
Ooh, Firestrike. That was like...
I love that, like, impending doom.
Yes, yeah, like a car crash in slow motion.
Like I'm watching you fly through a windshield.
Okay, so I've got EMP and I'm like, we're gonna get this next corner for free. Do the grav. Yeah, do the grav and then I'll EMP it and that should be all we needed. But they grab back, so it actually causes our Sigma to click on it. Nice of them. I love the kill feed when it's showing so many like supporting characters for each kill and stuff like that. Watching our ults, pushing up with what we've got in the next bit. We handle this bit really well as well. No, Ryan. No, are we not? How many times do I have to teach you this lesson, old man? For real. Getting little bits of chip damage. You guys are really knocking them out, though.
Yeah, I'm willing to bet you that Ryan was not happy with you.
Yeah, he came out as ball. Junkrat tried to do what he could, but it was too late. I enjoyed that round.
I don't know, maybe that Ryan will learn that if he wants to counter you, he'll just go Junkrat.
Possibly. I mean, it's not too bad. The only trouble with Junkrat, though, is Sombra will listen out for when you do the Riptide and will usually be up in your face when you do it. We try and get cheeky here. There's Orisa left, but I think you call out that there's only the Bob on the point after you get rid of this Orisa.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't really face into a Bob either. There we go.
Pretty nasty bubble. Torb.
Aardvark pays off.
That Torb ragdoll was pretty excellent.
I love the ragdolls. That's a bit of shield work. They're using double shields, right? And that's the current meta. But you know what? If you just walk through the shields or walk around the shields don't exist. I can see if I can get a cheeky headshot. Sometimes when Ash throws the bomb, she'll sit still for a little bit. But they've picked up a McCree. So I had to watch the flashbang. Okay, I've got the EMP ready. I'm letting the team know. Let's make some magic happen. Team gets aggressive. There it is.
Grab into the EMP.
Yep.
And it's nasty.
Grav EMP is usually all you need. Anything more is not needed. But what's good about that is it builds up the entire team's ults. Because you can see we've got 3-4 other ults ready to go.
What we really need is EMP. You don't even need to put the grav in it. EMP's strong enough.
Baptiste just got his ready. And you're about to have yours as well, Dudley.
Mm-hmm.
Toast.
Gonna use that piece to help chew up some shielding. Yeah, Ryan misses. It's okay, but we took the point, right? And here's where they get silly with their ult charges. We effectively spawn behind them now. They really should fall back. It doesn't matter that we got killed here. Or whoever got killed. I didn't get killed because I'm Sombra.
You know what you also are? Stupid.
Azaria's like, Sombra, help me! I'm like, no problem, I mean, even if we die, we're right here. Look, they're still pushing onto the payload. It's such an untenable position. Waste of an ult. I don't care if it kills anyone, it's a waste of an ult.
I've gotten a lot of time from it.
But we really didn't slow down anyway. I mean, I get what you're saying. They got a few seconds here, but from the start of the game, we weren't really slowed.
I'd say they got a good 30 seconds of it. I'd say that Sigma was justified. The rest of them probably not, but the Sigma was definitely justified. He'll build his ult up quick enough for the next... for the second fight.
What I like here is your dragon catches his Deadeye.
Oh, yeah.
That was so...
Mm-hmm. Like, hey, you got a nice hold. I got one just like it.
There we go. And look at our ults being ready. We've got like 4. We just used one. My ultimate is ready. And I need this later. My ultimate is almost ready. I love playing Sombra, man. It's I like playing Sombra now that's 2-2-2. I was getting quite aggravated trying to play comp Sombra when it wasn't 2-2-2, because, like I said, people would just get really stupid picks around your Sombra. can see he wants to jump. He wants to jump. Not anymore, he can't. But I can't stay there.
You broke his legs.
Oh no, I forgot how to use legs.
That is just what happens when you hack Soldier, though. He's just... Hold up. Legs? What?
Pharah hack.
With Genji and Hanzo.
Harassing the poor Orisas with his sickeningly strong Symmetra Beam right now. They're thinking of changing her up, aren't they? Well, what was the changes that was about to come in?
Sentry damage down from 50 to 40 per second, ultimate life down from 5,000 to 4,000, and I think the duration is down from 10 seconds to 6 seconds.
Ah. Yeah, that's fitting enough.
And people hear a louder noise when getting hit by her beam.
Yeah, that's the thing. You get backstabbed by the beam so often, you don't realize that it's beaming you as a tank. You just see that your health is gone. Everybody using that wall. Whole hog got play of the game there, I'm pretty sure.
And Murbid down.
Make a wall.
I love hearing that notification for team kill, though.
And then I get to play some stuff I don't usually play a lot, like Soldier 76. I'm not a great Soldier 76. And I can point out what's wrong here. Well, you're dead. But I'm alive. I'm alive and I'm hurt. But Anna's call here was really good.
You weren't even looking anywhere near them. You're just like...
But see the Annie nade on the other two. Oh my word.
Rudy tootie, hey, no need aim and shooty.
If you give me a nano, I will like click my strongest stuff.
He'll click extra hard.
Mm-hmm.
My IQ is low. My hero is back. I hold left mouse button and kill your tank.
I'm like, they're coming in, I'm running back. Ryan charging onto point, but we've got the high ground, Anakin.
I'm after him. I want this boy.
You underestimated his power.
But it killed him. He underestimated my power.
I'm trying to save you, bud. I'm trying to save you, but... you were chased down by like three there. Yep, they did. Just checking on where everyone's spawning at. Oh, I was hoping that Holt would come just a second earlier. Oh, you picked up the Torbjorn here, that's right.
The mark pays off.
I really like some of these turret placements, actually. We'll get to talk about that.
I am a professional Torbjorn this week.
You know what? My win percentage on Torbjorn is actually pretty huge. It's actually
my
funny.
My win percentage on Torbjorn is like 80%.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, no, we checked. We have the exact same win percentage on Torb. We both got 82% win percentage.
I swear to God, if they keep shooting me with dragons in the back through a wall, it happens so many times, I'm tired of it.
This dwarf had reactions good enough to run away.
Did your turret there, did it stop a barrage?
It killed a Pharah.
It killed
so
a Pharah. I'm trying to remember if it stopped the barrage right there. We stopped an Earth Shatter as well there. I love this turret placement, you watch it. This was 10 billion IQ, watch this. I love it. I don't know how intentional that was, but that was perfect.
I know the trajectory of Torbjorn's turret. Make him waste his storm arrows.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just...
If I know anything about Torb, it's how to throw a good turret.
Uncle Dane the Torbjorn main.
I like this one as well.
Mm-hmm. See, I got them flick shots as Torbjorn.
Alright.
Flick turret up there.
So I'm trying a different position here. I know they're coming in from that side, so I'm like, you know what? If I keep a nice range here, I should be alright. I didn't know if they've changed anything yet, but they're pushing in on the left side. I don't get hit with the dragon in the back this time, which is nice. But look at that, under the shield. Cheeky Torbjorn.
That Sigma was so low health. My
Tim, that wrecking ball is out of there.
And yes, I finally hit a quad rocket. There we go. Boom.
Only because he stood around there for 2 minutes.
But for the most part, I'm just trying to crack shields. That's why I usually pick soldiers, is we need some shield break. And out of all the shield breakers, that's what I like. I'm like, if I kill the Anna there, it's so over, but then I'm like, oh no, she backed off, and there's a Doomfist around, I can get Doomfist, but she saves Doomfist! That Anna.
Y'all can't even aim with the aimbot!
Oh, please, I was aiming lots of stuff, there was just a lot.
look at this play!
Save yourself from the headshot with the turret, I love it.
Listen, when you're dwarf-sized, the turret is a perfect shield.
But I, like, come out of spawn, and I'm like, we're still gonna take care of that Anna! Like, you guys have put Anna on ignore.
Yeah.
Just overwhelming whatever's on point.
I love Torbjorn. He's a precious little dwarf.
I'm saying. It took us a while to do this last attack, though. We kind of got halted a few times, but we built up a couple of ults, and we're like, okay, we're going in, boys. We're going in. Just waiting for it. Breaking shield, breaking shield. There we go. There we go, I'm in position. This hog tries to get my number, you watch him, he encroaches in on me.
Good Doom. Area bubble, he might have got you there.
Yeah. Managed to pick up the Doomfist who jumped in on it as well, but then managed to focus down the hog. Your wall is great, I'm able to fire free into all of it. Position, position, position. So thanks for watching, I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Play DPS.
No, don't.